In this third lesson, I'm going to teach you how to make a blinking LED using an external breadboard. What you need for this tutorial is a breadboard, an Arduino, two jumper wires which are mil-mil, an LED, and a 470 ohm resistor. Breadboards come in a wide variety of choice. You have them in different sizes, different colors, but doing the same thing. They connect your components in the way you want to. Actually, they act as a flexible PCB. You can see here horizontally connected pins, and here vertically connected pins. So if I'm about to put in a wire like this, now all these little holes are connected with this wire. There is a gap over here and here on the top and the bottom. This breaks the connection. So these are connected, but not connected with these one. And the same goes for the opposite direction. These are connected, but not with this wire. If I want to overcome this problem, you can simply jump over the gap using a wire, and now all these pins are connected. There is a wide variety of LEDs on the market. An LED is a light emitting diode. As you can see, they have various sizes and various colors. And one thing to keep in mind when you're working with an LED are the legs. The legs have two different sizes, as you can see here, a long leg and a short leg. The longer leg is called an anode and the smaller one the cathode. Current is only flowing from the positive side to the negative side. If you happen to use your LED in the wrong direction, it won't light up. So basically, if you have an electronic project and your LED isn't working, check that your LED is connected the correct way. In our circuit, we're going to use a resistor. A resistor reduces the amount of current flowing through a circuit. As you can see, they have different colors and even different sizes, but basically they work the same. Their resistance factor is expressed in ohm. For example, this is 470k ohm, so 470,000 ohm. As you can see, there are these little colored bands on the resistor. By these bands, you can read the amount of ohm the resistor has. Below this video, I've put a link to a resistor calculator that you can simply enter the color codes and see how much ohm the resistor has, and also the opposite direction. If you tell how much ohm you want, it tells you what kind of colored bands to look for. Let's build our circuit. We start connecting the ground with the ground on the Arduino. As you can see, there are two grounds on this side. There is also a ground on the other side. I connect my smallest leg to the ground, and then I use my resistor to avoid any short circuit, because the LED uses a very low amount of current. It's almost near short circuit. Therefore, we put a resistor to avoid a direct short circuit between the ground and our 5-volt connector on pin 13. Why are we using pin 13? In the previous tutorial, we've blinked our built-on LED. Actually, this LED is connected to pin 13. So now we have created a circuit, which is exactly the same as we did before, but now with an external LED. I've uploaded the code to my Arduino, and as you can see, the LED is blinking simultaneously with the built-on LED. The current is flowing from 13 through the resistor, through the LED, to the ground. to prove that there is only one direction, I'm now switching the side of the pins of the LED. As you can see now, it's not blinking. Since the current will try to flow via the shorter pin to the longer pin, but that doesn't work because it's a light emitted diode. A diode avoids current to go one way and only allows it through one way. So now it's actually blocking our current. If I reconnect the LED in the right side, now you see that the current is flowing through.